can start now. Newton's first law of motion we are discussing. Newton's page number 50 something it was there. 69, 62 there. Newton's law. Newton's first law of motion. Okay. Okay. So what is the first law of motion?
Sir, page
Newton's
number.
First law, which governs the motion of a body. It's 60. Have you found? Okay. So
yes, sir.
Newton's first law of motion we are discussing, and what it was, that if your body is at rest, it will remain at rest unless any force is applied. It will remain at rest. Or, and if body is moving, okay, no force is acting, body is moving, it will continue to move in the same direction with the same speed. Now, to change the motion, we have to apply the force. Okay, it won't change its state of rest or state of motion. That is moving the same direction with the same velocity unless any force is applied. This is clear. So before Galileo, there was a view. Before Galileo, there was a view that a body at rest will apply force to move it. It will move. Okay. It holds after. It holds true after Galileo as well. Okay. But before Galileo, what was the view? If a body is moving, will require a constant force to keep the body moving with uniform motion. To keep the body in uniform motion. Why was such a view hold at that time? Can anyone provide an answer? That is, again, I tell you, if a body is moving, to keep the body moving in uniform motion, a constant force was required. Why such view was hold?
Because they observed and then they made a law, and they observed that everybody will come to rest. Its nature is to
after
come at
rest. Yes. So see what they observed. Anything we start to move. For example, you are pedaling the cycle. If you don't pedal, it will stop after some time. Why? Because there was one force acting. Opposing force was there. That was the frictional force. Okay. Because of the frictional force acting on the body, body will stop. So they have forgotten to take account into which force? This frictional force. That's why they told, they forget to take the frictional force into account. That is, frictional force is acting. Okay. So they said that a constant force was required to maintain the uniform motion. Okay. So after Galileo, what Galileo said, that there is no force required to keep the body in motion. So what Galileo is saying, neglect the frictional force. For example, there is no frictional force. So if once body is moving, it will keep on moving since no force is acting on it. No force, no opposing force is acting on it that can stop the body, or no force is acting to push the body more. Okay. So if no force is acting on a body, the body is going to retain the state. Okay. In simple words, we'll say if no external force is acting on a body, the body will retain the state. Retain the state. Whatever state it is, it will remain in that state. Okay. It won't change. It won't change the state. Yes.
Sir, in Earth, we have that friction. In a space, there is a friction or not?
Again, ask. In Earth?
In Earth, we have friction.
Okay. And here. Okay, Earth surface, it has friction. Different kinds of surfaces on Earth will have different kind of friction. Yes or no? For example, a smooth surface here somewhere. It can easily move, less friction force is there. Yes or no?
No,
it will
sir.
Move more.
Sir, I am asking that Earth have that friction force. So
friction.
Space also have.
Does space also have? Okay, you are asking that. Okay,
yes,
here you, if you consider Earth along with its atmosphere, okay? And now consider space. Is there anything in space? Space is vacuum?
No.
Nothing?
Yes,
in
sir.
Space. So, there is no friction. But see here, between Earth and its atmosphere, that is air, there is a friction or not? Earth moves, atmosphere as well moves. There is a friction. There is a friction between them. There is a friction between different layers of air as well. There is a friction between water flowing as well, different layers of water as well. For example, water is flowing on the surface. Yes. In space, there is no friction. Okay, you have seen the meteors and all, or consider as a stone flowing in the space with very speed, very high speed. Okay, you won't see any burning or nothing will happen. But as it enters the Earth's atmosphere, what will happen? Because of air friction, since it is moving at very fast, it starts burning.
Because of friction, start burning.
Heat energy will be generated, and because of that, it starts burning. Okay. In space, there is nothing, no friction. Okay. So what we are considering here, okay, what Galileo is considering is there, it is moving in a very, that is, no force is acting on the body. If no force is acting on the, no frictional force, nothing. If it is moving in uniform motion, it will always keep on moving. It will never stop. It will never stop since no force is acting on it. So this body is going to retain its state. Okay. This is clear. So according to Newton's first law, if your body is at rest, if it is in the state of rest, what will it be? It will remain in state of rest unless any external force is applied. Okay. Or if it is moving with uniform velocity, that is, it is moving in the same direction with the same speed. It will keep on moving with the same speed in the same direction unless any force is applied. Okay. Unless any force is applied. So Newton's first law, for example, this is the body. Okay. If it is at rest, it will remain at rest. No force is applied on it. Okay. Surface, there is zero friction between surface and the body. We are considering this one. Second case, when the body is moving. So this body, it is continuously moving with, okay, let the velocity speed be V. Okay. And it is moving with in uniform motion. That is, this speed remains same. It remains same and it is moving the same direction. This body is covering equal distance in equal interval time in the same direction, moving and moving. And no external force is acting. So it will never stop. It will keep on moving. Okay. Unless any external force is applied. So if external force is applied, it can change the state. It can start to move. Or if any external force is applied on it, it can change the direction or the speed or both. Understood now? So for change of the state, in simple words, we can say for change of the state or for change in the state, we require external force. This is Newton's first law. Okay. Unless any force is applied, the body will continue in the same state. Okay. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Now,
we'll discuss this Newton's first law in two parts. Okay. First is inertia. Okay. You can see the body will not change the state. Okay. That is inertia. Second, when force is applied. So we'll discuss in two parts. First is the inertia.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, this idea was given by Galileo, then why it is named Newton's law?
Okay, why it is named Newton's law?
Sir, because okay. That Newton described this in, and he proved this. See, in that paperwork.
These laws were given by Newton. This inertia thing, it was given by Galileo. Okay. Inertia. Okay. See what? Okay. We'll discuss that one. Inertia we discuss. You understand. Okay. Galileo only said that one. That he, if body is moving in a straight line with the same velocity, with the same speed, then it will continue to move. That is, the body is having inertia. That is, it won't change the state. It will retain the same state. The body will retain the same state. Okay. Unless any external force is applied. That was the law of inertia. Later on, Newton's put them in paperwork and all, I think. Galileo provided the basics and Newton's compiled them. You can say like that. Okay. So now we discuss inertia. What does inertia mean? Inertia. Anyone and in the class, inertia. We have discussed property that in class.
Sir, can I say?
Sir, when an object cannot change its state itself, it requires a force by some other body. It is
okay. Okay, little bit. See, we can say inertia means body, see here, inertia means to resist the change. To resist the change. For example, your parents are telling you to study and study, forcing you to study, but you are not studying. That means you are having good inertia or not. You are resisting that boldly. That resistance is called as inertia. How much you resist, that is your inertia. Okay. If your parents force you to study and start studying with a little force, that means you have less inertia. If they are forcing you more and more, still you are not studying. That means you are having a good amount of inertia. Understood this one? So you are resisting the change. Yes. Okay. So similarly, for example, a body is at rest. Okay.
Sir,
and a force is applied to it.
Sir,
yes.
More the inertia, then more the heat produced by that substance.
More the inertia, more the heat. Okay. Which kind of heat? Mental heat. How the heat will be produced? If body is not moving, force is applied, no work done.
Sir, I am talking about friction.
Friction.
Like more inertia, then more friction will be there.
Till body doesn't start to move, how heat can be produced? You can take your hand like this. If it is not moving. Okay. If it is not moving, no heat will be produced. So see here, you are applying force. You are applying force. This body is not starting. Okay. It means you have to increase the force and force. This is resisting the change. The body is resisting the change. Body is resisting the force. So this resistance is called as inertia. Okay. So property of the object by virtue of it tends to retain the state. Tends to retain the state or opposes the change. Then that property is nothing but its inertia. That ability to oppose. Okay. This property is called as inertia. So inertia is property of the body. It is property of the body. It depends on the body inertia. Different bodies will have different amount of inertia. So it is the inherent property of the body. Okay. Inertia is nothing but the resistance to the change. Okay. For example, a body is moving. Okay, it is moving in uniform motion, no force is acting. Now, we want to change its state. So, we will apply the force on it. For example, we want to stop the body. This body will resist the change. This body do not want to stop, but we are applying force to stop it. Okay, so this body is resisting. So, more the resistance, more the inertia. So, inertia is the property of the body, or we can say it is the virtue of the body by which the body wants to retain its original state. That is, if it is rest, it wants to always stay in rest position. The body always wants to stay in rest position. If it is in motion, that is moving the same direction with the same speed. If it is in uniform motion, it always wants to stay in the uniform motion. That is moving the same direction.
Sir, why it wants to be in rest position?
Again ask.
Why the body wants to be in a rest position?
Okay. Okay, that you, okay, we'll discuss mass, you understand there, okay? Just wait for a minute.
Can
okay?
you tell me yes? example of inertia?
Inertia will be discussed. We'll be discussing. We'll be discussing. Now we'll be moving to that only. Okay? This you understood? This resistance is called the inertia, okay? Okay? Okay, so this inertia, it depends on what? Inertia is the inherent property of the material. It depends on mass of the body. Mass of body. Okay, inertia depends on mass of the body. That is, if body is having more mass, it will have more inertia. It will have more inertia. If body is having more mass, it will have more inertia. Okay, so you can take one example here. Okay, for example, you are having one truck at home, okay, and one car at home, okay. Now, you start to push, okay, you start to push. Which body will require more force to be pushed? Same distance. Truck will require. Truck will require. So which is resisting more? Truck is resisting more the change or the. So you can see when you try to push the truck, you require more force to push it to change the state from rest to motion. Whereas you will require less force to change the state of the car from rest to motion. So here means this body was resisting it more. The truck was resisting more. It was resisting the change. So it means the truck is having more inertia. Truck is having more inertia, more resistance power, you can say. It is having more resistance power as compared to this one. So we will say truck is having more inertia. Okay. Now, for example, both the bodies are moving with same velocity. Both are moving with the same velocity in the same direction. Okay. So both are having uniform motion, same velocity. So which, and you try to stop them. Okay. They are coming on the road and you try to stop them. So what will happen?
Sir, either we will die.
Yes, that is for sure to happen. Okay. But in physics, we can take ideal case. In physics, we can say that you try to stop, you have the immense power to stop them, immense force. Okay. So you try to stop both of them. You apply F1 here, you apply force F2 for the car. Both are moving with the same velocity, but mass are different. You can see mass of truck is much, much more than mass of car. Yes or no? So you apply the force. Which body will apply more force to stop? You require
truck.
You will require more force to stop. It means it was resisting the change. The truck was resisting more as compared to the car. So it means truck was having more inertia. Yes or no? Which kind of inertia? Inertia of motion. It was having more inertia of motion.
Yes.
Okay. This is clear. Inertia now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. As an example is given in your book of tennis ball and cricket ball. Okay. So if both the balls, you apply the force, tennis ball and cricket ball. You apply the equal force on the both the balls. Which ball will have more velocity?
Tennis ball.
It will have more velocity. This will have more velocity. Why? Because it was not able to resist much. It will have less velocity. It has resisted the force less. So it resisted the force more, this cricket ball. Therefore, it will have velocity less as compared to tennis ball. Okay. If both the balls are moving with the same velocity, which ball you will require more force to stop?
Cricket ball.
Because it has more mass, more inertia. So it do not want to stop. So you have to apply more force to stop it. So this property of resistance is called as inertia. So inertia is the property of the body by which body want to retain its original state. If it is in stress, it want to always stay in rest. If it is in motion, it always want to stay in the motion. That is uniform motion. This is clear. This is inertia.
Yes.
Second was the force. That is the external force. To change the state, we require force. Okay. External force is always required to change the state. Okay. This is clear. Okay. Now we are discussing. So inertia is of two kinds. You have to be which two kinds? First is the
inertia of rest.
When the body is at rest, it wants to retain its rest position. This inherent property of the body is called as inertia of rest. Okay. Second was body was in motion. Body wants to remain in motion always. This is called as inertia of motion. This inherent property of the body is called as inertia of motion. Okay. So few examples we discuss now. See here, now you will see many applications in real life. What you do the work, those all works here. Those are things you do, you will get an idea why does such things happen, okay? Okay, first we are discussing all the examples of inertia of rest. Okay, if your body is at rest, it wants to retain its rest position, inertia of rest. That is, if your body is at rest, it wants to remain in the rest position. So see the first example, this time we are having train, okay? okay, and there is a door. Okay, so when the train starts, okay, for example, we all are standing the train, okay, we all are standing the train facing this side. Now the train starts, what will happen?
We will fall.
You all lean backward. Yes or no? You will feel that you lean backward. You lean backward, you tend to move backwards. You tend to fall backward, yes or no? So what is happening? For example, this is the compartment, okay? And here you are standing, okay? And these are the legs, okay? You are standing, okay? Now, what will happen? As you are standing, initial train is at rest. You are also at rest. Our whole body is at rest. Now, train starts to move. Train starts to move. We fall backward. Why? See what is happening. As train starts, our lower body, it is in contact with the train. It is in contact with the train.
Yes,
so
sir.
It also gain the motion. It also moves forward. It also gain the motion. It moves with the same velocity as the train. But see, upper body, it is still at rest. It wants to be at rest position. So see what is happening. You are standing like this. Train moves like this happens. Upper body at the same state. That is, it wants to retain its in rest position. See, if this is the body, this is the head, you can tell it. Okay. Now, as train starts to move, your lower body is in contact with the train floor. So it will share the motion. It will also move forward. But your upper body, it is at rest position. It wants to be in rest position. And you don't want to move forward. So what happens? See here, train moved like this. So you fall backward. Understood? Your upper body want to retain this state of rest. Therefore, you fall backward. Is this clear?
Sir?
Yes.
Yes?
Sir, if the upper body and lower body both are in contact with the train, then sir, what will happen?
Okay. Now, for example, you are sitting in the train. See, you are standing. You fall backward more. Now you are sitting. Okay. Okay, this time you are sitting, okay? Now what will happen? Crossed legs, okay? Now what will happen? Your lower body will be in contact. Your upper body, you will feel less falling backward. Now this time you feel little bit falling backward. Or for example, you are sleeping in the train. You won't feel that much, yes or no? You won't
yes.
fall backward that much. So, while you are standing, your lower body will come in contact with the floor and it will share the motion of the train. So, it will also move forward. Train is moving, you will also move. But upper body, being at rest, it wants to be at rest position and you will fall backward. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now next one. I think next is a carpet. Okay. See here, you all do this one. We hang a carpet. Okay. Now with the stick, we start to beat it. What you see? Dust come out? Yes or no? Dust used to come out?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir.
For example, take this as a carpet. Okay. This is the carpet. Okay. Now see here, what you do? As you beat with the stick, what will happen? The carpet moves backward. The carpet is set in motion, yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But what about the dust particles?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
It's fine. I understood. Okay. So what happens? See here. Initially, your carpet as well as the dust particles, they are in rest position. Both are in rest position.
Yes, sir.
Rest state, state of rest. Now, as you beat it, your carpet moves backward. But see here, carpet moved backward along with the stick. They are set in motion. But what about the dust particles? They were at rest and they want to retain the rest position. So, for example, this is the dust particle. This is the dust particle here. Okay. Now, as it is beaten, it moves backward. But the dust particle remains there. Now, it falls down due to gravity. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's fine, Vedant. Third one, on shaking the branches of a tree, the fruits fall. So, for example, this is our tree. okay, and this is one branch. Okay, here we have apple or mango, whatever fruit we want. Okay, now as we shake the branch, for example, this is the branch and this is the fruit. As we shake the branch, what will happen? The branch will be set into motion and the fruit...
Sir, the apple will fall.
The fruit want to retain the state of rest. So if it is weakly attached, what will happen? This will set in motion, but it want to retain the state of rest. So branch set in motion, it want to retain the state of rest. It will break and it will fall because of gravity. Understood?
Yes, sir. The motion does not transform from the branches of the tree to the fruit.
Okay, it will transfer. See here, they are weakly attached, for example. So it starts to move. So here where it is the motion getting transferred. But till then, the body want to retain the state of rest. Okay, so see here, if it is strongly attached, what will happen? You will see the fruit as well moving along with the branch now. That means you have to set it in more motion to make it fall down, depending on the how strongly it is attached. Okay, so weakly attached. So see here, this branch, as you set in motion, upper part starts to move, but lower part, it is still in state of rest. So with time, the motion will go to there, will be shared by the whole body. Till then, it has moved more forward. So it will break away. So this one to retain the same position. So sharing of motion will take time. From here to here, it will move. So little bit. So as you move, it moves fast, it will move there. Little bit. Till then, branches move more faster. So there is a strain developed in the where it is being joined, where it is being connected with the branch. And because of that, it fall down now. In simple words, we can say it want to retain the state of rest. Branches move, so it will fall down. If it is strongly attached, it will also move with the branch. Okay? This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Now, you all have played the carom.
Yes, sir.
And we have the carom coins, black, yellow, or sometimes white as well, and red as well. Okay, so if you are playing the caroms, you have seen, if you are strong at the start, we set them in piles, one pile or two piles, depending on that. Okay, now we have the striker. Okay, striker, as we, this pile is, yes?
Sir, if we kick with high pressure to striker, then the coin which is on the bottom, it will only move and the pile will remain same.
Yes. That is very momentarily we have, where it's a huge force. Okay. If we now the striker we have. This is in rest position. Striker we have. Okay. As we strike it, we apply the force striking second motion. It touches this, the lowest coin at the bottom. Coin at the bottom it touches and share the motion. So this coin moves out. What happens? The whole pile takes the original position again. Whole pile moves down, rest position again. So what is happening here? This whole pile want to retain the same state. This whole pile want to retain the state. So only the lower pile has moved, okay? If you strike slowly, you see it will become like this. For example, this is the pile. We strike, you see it will become like this, the whole pile. What is happening? Lowest coin has moved more. It has the less, okay? Upper coin has moved little less. Upper coin, little less. Yes or no?
Sir, so they have 90%.
Yes. Or if very fast we move, what will happen? The lowest coin moves forward, rest puts there. Okay? So this, as why it was slanting, they have shared the motion. How? Through frictional. Friction was there. If very less friction, the lowest coin will move. Rest will take the original position. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Last, you have done one experiment. You have taken the tumbler and with this you stop the class. Okay. Tumbler, you take one.
Sir, time over.
1 minute I'm taking. Before just 1 minute. Okay. So we are having a cardboard, smooth cardboard. Okay. Place a coin over it. Okay. Place a coin over it. Okay. Now, flick it sharply. With a huge force, apply a huge force for just a small moment. Flick it sharply, what will happen? This cardboard will set into motion, it will move away. What about coin will fall in the tumbler? it will fall into tumbler. Why? Because it want to, the coin want to retain the state of rest. It want to retain the state of rest. So as we moved, cardboard was set into motion, it moved away. But coin want to retain the state of rest. And since it was smooth, coin lying on a smooth surface, very less friction, so it will move very less forward. And because of gravity, it will fall down. Because of gravity, it will fall down. Understood now?
Yes.
Next
yes,
corridor, sir. I will yes, discuss sir. Next tomorrow. Sir. Okay. Coin in motion. Yes.
Sir.
Why
the coin did not move away with the cardboard?
Thank you, sir.
You can do this experiment at home as well. See here. Take the tumbler, take the cardboard. If it is rough cardboard, if we hit it, the coin will move more with the cardboard. Yes or no? Okay, see here. If this is the pen, if I move it, this one. This pen want to retain the state of rest. So you see, it moves in this direction. You see like this? It was at rest. If there is more friction, what will happen? It will as well move, but let's slide bit in this direction. Okay? It will resist the motion. Now it is in the same position. It will resist the motion. So you can do this experiment with the tumbler and a cardboard.
Sir.
Apply less force, it will move. Apply more force very momentarily, it will move away. And the coin will
sir.
Yes.
Sir, it is also possible that the coin has more mass than the cardboard, so the coin falls into the tumbler. And the cardboard bends away.
Okay.
So it can be possible.
It can be possible as well. More the mass as well, but it is mainly because of friction. That is, the coin is not able to share the motion of the this one. It will want to retain the motion, but since there is no very less friction, so it won't move forward. If more the mass is there, it will. If it is having more the mass, it will resist more. Okay, resistance power is depending on the mass of the body. Okay, if you take the paper, it will may move with this. Okay, it may not resist that motion. Okay, you can try with different points or different. Okay, thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all.